What do you do here at Khan Academy?
I'm a developer, so I write code. So I've actually been here for exactly 1 year now. Today is my
Oh,
conniversary.
happy conniversary.
Thank you. And during that time, I worked on various things, from starting out working on adding a feature that lets users share their Khan Academy badges on Facebook using the Facebook Open Graph protocol. I've also worked on an early version of what are now known as tutorials on the site, which I'll provide a little more cohesive experience where you can experience exercises and videos together in a common playlist. 3 months ago or whatnot, 6 months ago, that wasn't available and that was kind of crazy. But like now we're in a brave new world of better organization and a better experience for our users. So I'm excited about that. I've also worked on making a bunch of exercises. So pretty much all the matrix exercises that are available, I worked on, and also this interactive exercise called visualizing derivatives, in which you can move a derivative and match it up with its original function or vice versa. And then most recently, I'm working on growth initiatives. So figuring out how to get more of our users who are using the site to sign up, and also encouraging more users to come use the site as well.
That sounds like a lot of big undertakings. I understand that you also, in your free time, created an exercise browser.
Yeah, I did, I guess. That was kind of like a side project. Essentially, I had been having this problem where I tried to find exercises as reference material when I was developing the exercise that I was working on, and I found it was like really difficult to find that content both on the sort of developer server that I was using and also on the live site. And I was chatting with Maureen, who is one of our school implementations associates, and she told me that a lot of teachers have this problem too. They have a hard time finding content that matches their curriculum or that matches gaps in their curriculum that they want to fill with Khan Academy exercises. And so I found this nice little synergistic like need. And I worked I used the work of a former intern at KA, Dylan, who is awesome and amazing and joining full time soon. He had made this screenshot generator for exercises. And so we used that screenshot generator. I use screenshots from that screenshot generator to create this like more visual type of way of browsing exercises on Khan Academy, and that's that. Yeah, it's pretty small and
But
not that.
it sounds like that you proactively saw a need and then went to fill it, which is pretty awesome. Tell us a bit about yourself and what was your background and how you ended up at Khan Academy.
Thanks. So I guess I went to Duke University in North Carolina. I graduated from there in 2011 with a degree in electrical and computer engineering and a minor in CS. But actually, I didn't really do a ton of coding when I was at Duke, like just mainly class projects and not really a ton of side projects. And I don't really feel like I stood out. I definitely enjoyed a lot of the classes that I took, but they were very challenging for me, and it didn't really come naturally. So when it came time to choose a job or whatnot, I felt like my skills and talents were more on the order of perhaps communication, which may or may not be the case, and project management and organization. So I felt like maybe being a program manager or consultant would be more appropriate for me. But I worked as a program manager for Microsoft and their search ads team in Mountain View for a short time, 5 months. And during that time, I realized that I was looking for something where I would have a little more responsibility and more direct impact over the product, because as a member of a 400-person team, it's hard to do that. So I looked around and I saw that Khan Academy had some offerings, and it was pretty exciting. I had seen the TED Talk and I was really inspired by it. And I applied after a couple months of prep.
because you saw that there was a need for software developers, you decided to train as one. So what did you do to prepare for that? What resources did you use?
Yeah, so I guess like I had some basic knowledge of software development from my computer science courses. Specifically, I'd only done really 2-3 coding courses in college, but I knew like Java, I guess, but that's pretty different from web development. So I ended up doing this like Ruby on Rails like crash tutorial type thing to try to understand more, and that ended up being a little bit over my head. And kind of backed up a little bit. I did learn a lot of good things from there, which are on the order of like just how web applications work and how the client, so your computer communicates with the server, and that kind of stuff. That was really valuable. But I stepped back and I said, you know, let me like just focus on like individual components. Like I'm not gonna learn Python right now. I'd done a little bit of Python programming before, but I said I'm gonna like mainly focus on the parts that I don't know, which are like HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. So it turned out that the Khan Academy exercise framework was a great place to actually learn that stuff. And so I ended up carving out like a challenge for myself to make an exercise that I didn't know if I could make, which was the telling time to module.
So it became an actual exercise on our website.
Yeah, that was really cool. So I worked on this for like 2 or 3 weeks or something, and like just straight. And I was getting my first code review comments back, and like it took a while to get feedback because the devs were very busy and stuff. But it was incredible to like get that kind of feedback and to like understand. Oh, you know, we don't use our. I'm not sure we. Use spaces instead of tabs and stuff like for our JavaScript formatting and just basic suggestions about how to do things better. That was really neat. But then what was way cooler was when the exercise went live and there were like a bajillion bug reports from day one, and I was monitoring like the issues page like constantly in like the issues tab of GitHub. And it was exhilarating because I was like, oh my God, people are actually using it. Like, and I did like some basic calculations. I was like, okay, so we're getting like maybe 100 bug reports a week. So that means like maybe 10,000 people are using it. I don't know. And I was so excited. Normally bugs aren't cause for celebration, but I was happy because I looked through each of the bugs and I found that most people were just confused about the settings of a clock. To their credit, it's a pretty challenging exercise because nowhere in reality do you ever have to set like the hour hand and the minute hand separately. So that's I think fair. Thankfully, there were no glaring technical issues.
So it sounds like you invested quite a bit in applying to Khan Academy. What drew you to Khan Academy in the first place? How did you decide that this was the place you were going to make a career?
So I guess I'd been looking around and I had like a short list of places that I was looking at. I definitely, after having worked in ads, I was certain that I wanted to do something that was more oriented towards solving a big world problem. I was just blown away by Sal's TED Talk, in which he references this graph, which is actually from our coach dashboard, which shows this student, this low performing student at like the bottom, maybe 10% of students, and how over time this student makes incredible progress and ends up at like the near the top of their class. And that's just incredible to me because in today's school system, we identify children at a very young age as gifted or not gifted. And so in a traditional classroom or a traditional educational system, that child might have been just like judged as not being talented, not being gifted, not having the ability to perform. And I think that's sad and absurd. And I think this kind of very concretely proved that that doesn't have to be true. And that you know, if you give people resources and empower them, that they can become incredible people and achieve like really outstanding goals. So I think that was awesome. And I felt that if Khan Academy is making that the norm, then I want to be there. I want to be helping with that mission.
And how has it been since you've come to Khan Academy?
Pretty amazing in all respects. I think like the caliber of the people that you work with is just mind-blowing. Like, I feel very incredibly fortunate to work here, and I think it's like, it's kind of a dream come true, and I definitely feel very underqualified for this position, so yeah.
But you made it through somehow. I think, I remember when you applied, I was still screening resumes, and your application actually stood out distinctly, and I think to this day is still the one that stood out the most, and it was because you had created like a reimagination of what our exercise platform could be. Which, how long did that take you? What was the investment of time to not only learn to code, but also make this like reimagining document?
Yeah, so I guess I tried to do a redesign of the exercise browser, and that was like a big challenge because I was very noob at CSS at the time, and I was doing everything like the hardest way possible, probably. I think that took me like several weeks maybe, and creating but obviously, like, the sad thing is now that like I have learned things the right way, I could probably do that in like half an hour, which is a little tragic, but maybe also encouraging, who knows.
I think you're probably giving yourself too little credit for how quickly you were able to learn and impress the interviewers to be able to get past those screens. So I do want to ask, I mean, you came to Khan Academy because of the vision. What is your vision of what Khan Academy could be in the future, you know, maybe in 100 years?
So, I think one of the cool traditions that we have here is that we mail every intern who accepts an offer, and possibly full-timers, a copy of The Diamond Age by Neal Stephenson, which is subtitled A Young Lady's Illustrated Primer. And that outlines a vision for a future where young children from very, very young ages get this book that is incredibly interactive and customized to their needs and teaches them how to overcome all kinds of hurdles, like emotional hurdles in their lives, and empowers them to take ownership of their education. And I think it actually presents a very, very unconventional model of education in that, like, I'm actually not a huge fan of traditional education. I don't think I learned a whole lot from that. I think, like, this model has a really special focus on children as individuals and helping them conquer whatever are the main obstacles in their lives. And so I think there's a huge behavioral and emotional component to being empowered, and I think that's actually probably one of the bigger hurdles that kids face in, you know, all around the world today. How can I, like, just metacognitive skills, like how can I focus when I'm getting distracted? How do I stop negative feelings about myself from distracting me from studying? How do I overcome bullying? These kinds of problems. It would be awesome if Khan Academy can someday begin to tackle some of these big, like, really big problems and help, you know, clear students' minds so that they can actually get inspired about math and science and history and all the other cool subjects that there are out there. By the way, I'm not a huge fan of subjects either, and I think it's really weird and artificial how we've, like, abstracted them away into different domains, because I think they're all interrelated, and we'll probably learn better when we have some sort of, like, narrative that, like, arcs around, and, like, pretty much what Britt Cruz is doing right now. So take a look at his stuff. Yeah.
That sounds like quite a vision. It's metacognitive and, you know, emotional needs and, you know, being able to fulfill and non-subject-oriented but very cross-disciplinary learning. It'd be very exciting to see that come to fruition. Well, thank you so much for joining us today.